Hi, and welcome to the Computer Architecture and Assembly Language course on Ecampus at Oregon State University. My name is Paul Paulson. It really is. Over the years, my signature has evolved to Paul Squared Son. I mentioned this so you'll recognize my signature in emails, etc. For nearly 30 years, I've taught just about every computer course under the sun, from programming in several languages to computer networking and advanced operating systems. I've taught in New York's SUNY system and in places like Malaysia, Taiwan, Japan, and a decade here at OSU. After all these years, teaching all these courses in all these places, what's my absolute favorite course to teach? This one, Architecture and Assembly Language. It has always turned out to be an amazing journey. Many students are baffled at first because the course content is so very different from topics covered in earlier courses. And assembly language programming can seem like the very heart of darkness. But I really think that by the time you complete this course, the lights will be on and you will have a much deeper understanding of why it's important. The main theme of CS271 is how computers work. I have often heard students and even professors say that one doesn't need to know how a computer works to be able to use it, to program it, etc. In fact, some important and respected computer scientists have said, computer science is no more about computers than astronomy is about telescopes. This quote is often attributed to Edgar Dijkstra, Hal Abelson, and others. And there's certainly some truth in the idea. The prevailing analogy is that you don't need to know how engines, transmissions, and so forth work to be able to drive a car. Unless, of course, you pilot a 1948 MGTC, like I do. Or perhaps you're seeking a deeper understanding of how machines work, specifically the machine you have chosen as the focal point of your profession. But be all that as it may, there are three very good reasons to learn about how machines work. First, if you understand how computers work, you will have a better idea of what to do and whom to believe when problems and disasters occur. I'm sure you've had software support tell you that the problem is in the hardware, and hardware support will tell you that it's a software problem, which usually doesn't help to solve the problem. The second reason is there is strong demand for computer scientists who understand enough about computer hardware to be able to communicate with hardware developers. There is a tremendous boom in developing programs for embedded devices, device drivers, big data storage and retrieval systems, high-speed graphics, and so forth. We frequently hear from our industry contacts about the importance of integrating hardware-software teams. The third reason is that figuring out how things work is a natural drive for problem-solver types. So this course can help you to satisfy your innate sense of curiosity. There is another reason to learn about architecture and assembly language. You might find out that you love it, as I do, or you might hate it. Very few students end up in the middle of that spectrum. Perhaps you will love it enough to develop your career around some of these topics. Fat chance, you might be thinking, because on the other hand, you might find out that you do not want ever, never, ever in your life to have anything to do with low-level programming. But either way, these are good things to know when you start looking at job descriptions. Now, about the course format. Some of the lectures are simulated whiteboard talks, and some are slide presentations. In the lectures, I will emphasize the main points of the reading and the slides. The lecture slides will be posted, so you can review them at your convenience. Just a bit of a disclaimer. The first week is rather intense, as we set up the foundation and the framework for the course. Some of the material will be reviewed for some of you, but do look at all of it to be sure that we are on the same page. In subsequent weeks, we will focus on more specific topics. Be sure to read the Welcome to CS271 document on the course website. It briefly describes the course, the prerequisites, and the system requirements. There are also links on this week's calendar to the systems you will need for assembly language programming. Be sure to follow the directions carefully, especially when installing the textbook's library. Contact us if you have trouble getting set up. Remember to contact us if you have questions. There is one prerequisite that is not mentioned in the document, and that is perseverance. Assembly language programming can be frustrating to say the least. Be persistent and use the available resources. One of the most important skills you can develop is the ability to figure out how to figure things out. You can do this. So, welcome to CS 271. I'm really glad you're along for the ride.